2, verse 41 to 47. Acts 2, 41 to 47. It says this: those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 were added to their number that day. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching, to the fellowship, to the breaking of bread, and to prayer. Everyone was filled with awe, and many wonders and miraculous signs were done by the apostles. All the believers were together and had everything in common, selling their possessions and goods they gave to anyone as he had need. Every day they continued to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their homes and ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying the favor of all the people. And the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. This is the word of the Lord. And at this time we're going to have a special song for the choir, from the choir.
Characteristics
of the church. Let me share with you a few of them this morning. The first one, the first characteristic is the church is complied with committed believers. We have, we are founded, and that's the first characteristic that we have. Believers that have a commitment. Look, verse 41. Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 were added to their number. That day, they added 3,000 people. They were baptized. They accepted the message. And that is the first thing for a commitment. If we want to know how a believer can be have a commitment with Christ, first step is they accepted the message of the Word. They had the same message. Everybody heard the same message that Peter preached. He preached about Jesus, the Messiah, the Savior, the Lord, the one that died for our sins and resurrected from the dead. That was the message, and they accepted the message. All of them accepted the message. So if we want to have believers with commitment, they need to accept the message. Not only that, they were baptized. All of them were baptized. That is a challenge. All of them were baptized. That means that they made a commitment. They made a personal commitment. When you were baptized and you profess your faith, you make a commitment not only with the Lord, but you make a commitment. Understand. So committed believers, and they confessed their faith publicly. They were baptized 3,000, and everybody knew about that. There is no turning back. Remember that song? There's a song on that. There's no turning back. You made that commitment, you were baptized, in public, everybody saw it. Everybody saw you saying, I believe, I accept, I will follow, I will be part of it, I will get involved, I will help. Everybody saw it's a public commitment. And we need to understand that. This is part of the church. If we want a church that is a church like this one here, we need this kind of people. We need to be this kind of people. Believers that have a commitment. But not only that, not only believers with commitment. We need one more thing to be a church. One more characteristic that this text helps us to understand is to grow together. Grow together. That is the second characteristic of the church. Verse 42, we have this. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to the fellowship, to the breaking of bread and to prayer. And verse 46 says, every day they continued to meet together in the temple courts. Every day. How they do that? How they grow together? They grow together through this a serious study Bible, study the Word of God. That's very important. We cannot grow in our faith without the Word of God. We need to study. We need to read. To study the Word of God. It's very important for us to study the Word of God. Second, intense prayer life. We need to pray. And we saw that. We saw that a few weeks ago. We saw that about prayer. All of us, we had a series about prayer. And prayer is important. We need to pray for each other, and we need to pray with each other. And this is what they're doing here. They're not only praying for each other, they were praying with each other. They had small groups all over the town because they didn't have a temple. They didn't have a place where they could worship. They would go to public squares. They would go to the plazas and stuff around the temple. They could not have access to the temple because the temple was restricted to only men. So if you had a meeting that would include women, you had to have a meeting beside the court temple. And they had a kind of plaza there where people would stay around and sell things and just walk around. And they would have a corner there just for the group to meet, to pray, to study, pray together. And then they would go to their homes, safer, better. They would do that. Intense prayer life and regular public meetings. Regular public meetings. The Bible says that they would meet every day. And we think that, well, for them it was hard to meet every day. No car. How are they going to go? Where are they going to go? No internet, just know where the place is going to be. No GPS to find the address of the person where Peter lives. Oh, today the meeting is going to be where? I don't know. I didn't receive the bulletin. I didn't receive the email. They found a way to do it. They found a way to do it. Meeting constantly. I know that we have some meetings here, we have some groups here. It's good. The choir meets every Wednesday, so it's great. So they know what's going on, they talk to each other. Then we have the ladies' group, and then we have men's breakfast once a month. It's kind of, but yes, we have something going on. And then we have the circles, and then we have the shepherds. We have a little bit here, a little bit there. Can we group? Yes, we can. I remember when I was pastoring in Brazil, this would be my normal week. If everything goes okay, this would be my normal week. Tuesday, I had a prayer meeting, and I had to lead the prayer meeting. We talk about prayer meeting, we talk about the pastor will be present, he will read the Bible text, he will make a meditation, and then everybody will pray. Wednesday, we have a Bible study. When we talk about Bible study in Brazil, we're going to have a 30-minute service with songs and prayers and everything, and then 40, 50 minutes Bible study. And then Saturday, we have a youth service. A youth service with new, what? A new service. The youth would lead the service with all the parts, and they're going to do music, they're going to do the song, the prayers and everything, and the pastor will preach a sermon. 40 to 50 minutes of sermon. And then Sunday morning we would have Sunday school. Alright. Only Sunday school. What we have in Sunday school? We have an opening. What that means, an opening? We come together, all the members of the church come together Sunday morning, and we sing, we pray, there is a short meditation, and we invite everybody in their classes. The youth, the lady, the man, adult, whatever, all those classes. And they have their Bible study, they come back, and then we have a closing. What's a closing? A closing is we sing, we pray, and the pastor do another meditation to close. Everybody go home. That is around 11, 12 o'clock, Sunday morning. And then, Sunday evening, everybody comes back for the service. The main service in Brazil is 7:30 in the evening, an hour and a half. Some churches go 2 hours. And the pastor has to preach around 40 to 50 minutes again. Almost every day. There are no churches that they meet every day. It's a kind of, come on. Well, here I have to prepare 40 minutes of Sunday school class, a sermon. And all the other things that I have to write for the bulletin and everything else, and kind of, oh man. And then when I start complaining, I hear a voice say, did you miss Brazil? Did you miss Brazil? You want to go back? Tuesday, Wednesday, Saturday, Sunday morning, Sunday evening. I don't want us to become a Brazilian church in that sense, but we need to continue to find ways to grow together, to get together. Not only to meet, go together, get together, to pray, to help each other, to grow, to study. We need to find that we cannot grow without getting together. And this is very important for us as a church. So the church has believers that have a commitment and believers that grow together. We cannot be a church without those two. And next week we're going to see the other part. That is our heads and that is prayer. Father, we pray that you will help us to be the church that you intend. You have a plan for us. You have a mission for us. You have a project for each one of us to get involved in your kingdom. Help us to do that. Help us to participate somehow. Help us to influence, to touch other people's lives. Help us to touch our brothers and sisters' lives. Help us to grow together. Help us in our commitment with you and with the church. We pray in the name of Jesus.